Jordan, is that your nephew?
Yes.
He's our shy fellow.
This is Matthew.
Matthew, hey,
he's
Matthew.
He's our biggest fan.
All right. We got more paper. Who wants one of Jordan's paper cups?
16.
All right, you want the stripe? Come on, yeah, come here. Come here. All right, who wants one of Joe's? I want to go for the gals here, if you don't mind. All right, right here, yeah. Okay, this can go up. And Donnie, what's Donnie?
The girl behind the boy with the red sweatshirt.
Which one?
The girl behind the guy with the red and white sweatshirt.
Oh, no, this the one with the don't do.
Yeah.
Well, come over. Come on, Donnie wants you to come get his paper cup. And for Danny, who wants over here?
Thank you.
Right here. Yeah, go ahead. Come on up here.
Nobody wants to come.
This is souvenir time here on People Are Talking. What? We got pictures. That's right. We'll be giving away the chairs and everything else. All right. Let me ask you, Donnie, are you worried at all that this is, I mean, it's so big now that it's gonna dip off?
No, I don't have any fear of that. I mean, we're enjoying it anyway. If that's what happens, then I guess that's destiny. But I think our fans are growing up with us. I think what you were talking about, the Rolling Stone, it said they were that we may be just transitional objects. I don't think that's the case. I think that we're growing up with our fans. And as we get older, they'll be getting older, too. Mm-hmm. And as we, you know, go through different changes in life, our fans will be going to it. And, you know, since we are the same ages, I think that's an advantage. I mean, instead of being like a George Michael, who's probably 29 or 30 or something, and his fans are 15, when he gets 50, they're going to be, you know, long forgotten about him. They'll be married and stuff like that. So our fans
So you want your music to grow as you grow?
I think it's just bound to happen because that's what happens when you grow up.
Right over here, this young lady. Yep. You stand up.
Do you, when you're practicing, do you guys get in fights or do you always get along?
No. We get in fights just like everybody else, but we're like brothers, you know. We'll fight one second and the next second we'll, you know, be best friends again.
So. We were talking about haircuts before the moms came out. Any problems with the haircuts at all?
No. I just braided his hair before we came on, so I really like his hair.
Good.
He doesn't make the parade.
My mother gave me my first earring. She pierced me and Jordan's hair about 4 years ago with a needle.
But you understand, I'm so much older than all these women that I have a whole different outlook, so this is the way Joseph has to stay, you see. I'm the oldest mother, but I've got the youngest child, see, so they're all with it. But I'm a little beyond with
it. Beyond with it, the new album.
Beyond with it.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gone.
No. Go ahead.
When did you get a lot more fan mail than others?
It comes and goes. Like I think in the beginning I
reigned supreme.
I got the most mail with "Please Don't Go Girl" because I was the lead on that song and that was the first single, and then. It came like Jordan, and Jordan, you know, sang right stuff, and I'll Be Loving You, so he probably got the most mail. And then it went to Donnie. It just changes mostly with the single.
Right now.
I think it's Danny.
Yeah, Danny now. Yeah.
But it'll change. It just keeps changing.
Danny is on a roll. He's getting bags full of letters every day. The songs that he sings are released on the underground. So Danny is ruling right now.
Do you guys want to sing for the rest of your lives?
No. Maybe. No.
I want to entertain for the rest of my life. Mm-hmm. Not necessarily sing, but... You know, maybe whatever, you know.
You said you were going to be a writer.
Do your bodyguards treat you different from other
entertaining
kids?
Novels.
What? Say it again?
Do your bodyguards treat you different from other people?
Come on, G. You got to go. Come on.
Come here. Come here.
This is Z. This is Z right here.
Z, now this is Robo. Robo. Don't mess with Robo.
Oh.
What's the one incident that comes to mind that you really had to protect these guys? I mean, a bunch of screaming girls tearing at them or what?
Well, the kids, I find them amazing when I come down early to a hotel and I ask the kids not to come over and rush them, and the kids swear me down that they wouldn't do this. Mm-hmm. And their parents even cover them by saying, my child is the best child. They will never do this. And I take their word for it, and as soon as I come down, they go,
wow. They didn't know it all. They even burned you off. How about a hand for Z?
I was wondering what you guys did in your free time.
Sleep.
If you have any.
Sleep.
Free time.
We went to the movies last night and played gangsters.
We just do normal things, you know.
Where'd you go to the movies?
Somerville.
Somerville Theater. What happened when you went to the movies?
We're there every night. No.
somebody over here, I wish I was there, you said. What happened when you go to the movies? I mean, are you recognized immediately? Or?
Z's with us all the time. Yeah. So.
Uh-huh.
Robo.
Uh-huh.
There is commotion.
They got attacked after the movie, by me.
By him.
I attacked them.
You attacked them?
He snuck into my sidekick because there's like, it's a convertible.
Don't tell no one, Joe.
He didn't go to the movies with us.
Well, he had the key.
We came out of the movie theater, and he came out the rooftop of Joe's car.
He broke into Joe's car. He
said, you know, you could have got arrested.
Half your tricks on the past.
You'll be all right.
Was it hard to leave all your friends, like, when you had to go on the road?
But we bring them out sometimes, actually.
Good jizz.
Jizz.
I'm sorry,
no,
Joseph.
We're like friends. We have... You know, although sometimes I'm from Jamaica, and I hang around with my friends there, but I have just as good as time with these guys.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Do you think you'd ever split up or anything?
Do a Bobby Brown.
Well, for today, we're New Kids on the Block. Right. You never know what's going to go.
Well, our group, you know, it's best that we stick together because it's the combined thing that makes us work so good, mm-hmm. you know. Mm-hmm. Everyone's different, and that makes us so good, I think.
It's too hard
and
to tell.
If one person leaves the group, I think it would never be the same. So we're going to stick together.
Word.
All right, we'll be right back with New Kids on the Block with their moms after this.